Roger, roger. Alright, I think I can talk now.
Oh, man. Yeah, a lot of time mistakes in that room. Kashyyyk is really hard to save time on. It's really easy to screw up the last room and the first part, where you have to rescue all the Wookiees. Alright, we'll be going for Fast Vader. It saves 2 seconds. Gotta save time somehow. Shouldn't be too late. Got it. Oh no. Come on, press X. Alright, unfortunately I couldn't force that, because I was holding X in the wrong direction, so. Probably gonna go for the jump too. But yeah, the main reason why it makes that slower is you're not like doing direct 2-player pillars. It's like 1.5-player pillars. It's probably faster for the AI to do that too. Now, pretty much, Charmander, the enemies in that last room, based on the cycle, so if you're too slow, you'll get shot at. I was a little bit too slow there, because I didn't force the second cup for the beacon, so. That was nice. Oh, got it. Alright. It's really close to dying there. If I failed that, I would have lost at least 15. Still a good pace, though. I'm getting better at this game. I'd be a lot farther behind by now. Once I actually understood that doing the quick Jedi slashes is based on, like, timing instead of spamming it, oh, this is good gold, actually. No, it couldn't.
Roger, roger.
Oh, wow, it did gold. Even though I failed in that one room. Yeah, right now I'm super bad at Vader, that I can honestly gold either with slow or fast. I'm really bad at movement. But yeah, there's a trick in Kamino where you stay on top of a panel, and if you hold upright, you can access the loading zone of the next room, skipping a R2 panel, saving about 5 seconds in total. Yeah, still sub 21 by a fair amount. Not too bad. I will focus in Droid Factory though, because I actually want to save time in that stage. I might have been too late. Nope. Works every time. Yeah, for that, I mean, you don't have to push R4 all the way to the pillar, because you'll have enough time if you're halfway between the pillar and that scene to hold up right anyway. That was super delayed timing. I still got it. That spot's broken. Drop in now. On the left side, it's dumb. On the right side, it's actually kind of free. The timing is. R4 bridge skip is dumb. It's probably the worst trick in this game. pretty good. But yeah, there's a skip that's actually faster than the drop and ward by about a second, and it's called R4 bridge skip. Basically, from that platform the R2 is on, you can actually skip the drop and warp entirely and, like, fly from that platform to the door with R4. It's ridiculously precise. I know they do it in TCS. I think it's more precise in this game because of death planes or something. Because you have to travel around a death plane. That's, like, you have to go, like, down then around. Like, up. It's dumb. Yeah, I think they used to do it before they found out the drop and warp was viable. But R4 bridge skip is still technically faster. Even though, like, the movement is stupidly precise. But yeah, like you saw there, I was ahead of player 2 by the end. So... okay, I want to take at least one tick of damage here. Alright, I guess not. The robot's aim here is ridiculously inaccurate. Nice. Fast Kamina. Nah, it's fine, dude. Oh yeah, you can't hear me. But yeah, I was actually, like, delayed on my timing. With that drop and warp, I held up right a little bit too late, and I pressed start, I think, after the camera centered, and I still got it. So. Alright, I actually don't know what pace this is. I think I'm on gold pace. Oh yeah, I'm on hella gold pace. Yeah, I'm like 7 seconds ahead gold pace. Nice. Okay, that should be a big gold. Yeah, I think this should be a 525 or a 27. This is really good. I was afraid I was gonna miss that, but yeah, I've still never been able to get a 5-2x Kamino because I didn't know about the dropout strat for that transition skip. I got a stream notification. Oh, it's my friend streaming. Oh wow, it's really good.
Roger, roger.
All right, that's barely a 5-2x, I think, but I'll take it. 3 second gold is pretty good. At least it's a gold with the new setup. Because, yeah, I think the dropout is faster than R4 push if your dropout inputs are fast enough. But the thing is, you're trying to hold, like, forward in the analog stick of player 1 so he doesn't fall. And then you're trying to drop out with your other hand. And obviously, like, doing the dropout with 2 fingers is, like, slightly slower than doing it with, you know, 4 fingers. So... it's a little bit less optimal, so I can see why in TAS it would be a lot faster. But yeah, I think in the Destroyed Factory, I died twice in the conveyor section. I missed Turbo Bucket 10 times, but I got the cuff jump. I got the cuff jump first try at least. That was a worthwhile risk, IMO. All right, almost missed that. I almost missed the dropout, because immediately when that switch turns green, you have to drop out player two and then move player one into the bucket. It's a little bit reaction based. All right, this is a lot of time saved. I will take a death in the next room, though, because I took the droid deck apart kind of risky for the boost. I 100% took it risky. I can also activate that a lot sooner and start doing that. I don't want to die in there, so I'm just going to walk for now. Taking safe strats. Alright, got it. No deaths, though. That's good. Oh, no. Wait. Let's make sure. Okay, I think if I touch that, C-3PO might get stuck. Let's not take that chance. Okay, now I'm afraid that he's actually there. Because if he's there, I'm going to have to go back and get him. It's probably as much time loss as missing Terra Bucket 10 times. Alright, he's there. Good. This isn't a bad pace. I think I'm slightly ahead of my gold. Yeah, whatever. I think this could have golded if I didn't die in this room. Yeah, because that was really good. We're gonna be really ahead. I think I was a 4-2-3 entering that last room in my gold. How many of you guys are excited as much as I am? Dude, this is an insane pace still. Like, mid-101 pace going into Jedi battle? Seriously? Even if I lose a lot of time to Dooku, I'm still on third place pace by a very wide margin. Just do what I know. I want to jump slash in each of those transitions too. Gotta start doing that. I'll probably take a death here, for sure. I'm mistiming it. Oh well. Oh well, slow. Yeah, 135. It's why I have to time each deflect is what makes it hard. Because deflecting a bunch is easy, but... Yeah, Jedi Battle is something it's probably going to take me the longest to actually become competent at. Maybe he's on the right side of the bomb. No, he's probably on the... Yeah, he's on the right. Not the left. Sometimes he's on the right side of the bomb, other times he's on the left. It's inconsistent. With the pattern. Should have shot him earlier. Everyone should be on the right now. Nice, got him. I predicted that too. That's ridiculous. I'm gonna lose like 30 seconds again, because this game's done. Yeah, whatever. Oh well. Who cares? I'll still be ahead. I'll probably still be on 1-1 pace, which is not bad. I lost 26 seconds from doing the fight normally. Interesting. I only had like one iframe mistake. Yeah, I don't know. With me, I tend to understand things one at a time. And once I finally understand that one thing that's holding me back from actually achieving something, it becomes a lot easier. All right, I have to get a good Dooku too. Still be ahead. And if I don't, it's whatever. I can pull it back in late game. I lost a ridiculous amount of time on Maul. Yeah, 16 is beyond terrible. Yeah, I think in my PV I got second try barrel and I had a death drain lever skip. I still only lost 8 seconds. One heart's pretty average. I don't understand why this happens. Come on, dude. Yeah, first I get that, and then I get the dumbass setup. Alright, that was privilege in its purest form. Nice. Perfect. Yeah, I thought it was gonna pop out there. Alright, we're not losing a lot of time. That's good. That lever skip is beyond awful, though. Beyond awful. Wow, imagine if I didn't miss quick kill. Imagine how far ahead I would be. I think half of the speedrun is just cutscenes. Yeah, it's fortunately the case with most LEGO games. Yeah, and player 2 got conveniently dropped out when I did that lever skip for some reason, so don't have to do any controller shenanigans. I feel like I gotta jump more to the left there so I can get bumped by that creature going into the cutscene. Yeah, what did I think of a oh yeah, I died during the second Jar Jar jump. I did die during that. The raw warp is the more important part for this level. And this jump. That was clutch. I was gonna die there. Should have delayed more. I don't think I'll work. Yep. Alright, that was bad. Oh well, I think we're going even. I think. I think I forgot how to have not a bad out of bounds for... Yeah, I think I'm losing more time because I severely screwed up the... Yeah, I lost time during that raw warp, but I think I rotated the stick too early, so I bumped against the wall. Bad out of bounds. I died during the first Jar Jar jump, and I got bumped by that creature. So yeah, it's, I don't think we're saving time. That's fine, though. It's, this stage is really hard. I played out of my mind to get that 3-3-2. Everything was good. I think it was only a couple of frames off of my IL record where I grinded for hours and I got that in a run. To even get that. Yeah, only one of my runs is at a really good Invasion, and that was my 103-13, which was the PB before this. The worst mistake is in the Star Wars saga, Qui-Gon saving Jar Jar. Well, if you think about it, I mean, Jar Jar indirectly caused the Sith tyranny. Because he was in the Senate in Attack of the Clones, and yeah, it was dumb. Alright, I'm just gonna use Padme. Hearts? Alright, didn't get the heart there. It floated away from me. I could die in this room. No? Oh my god. I can't believe I didn't die. At all. Yeah, it was all the Gungan's fall, for sure. Oh wow, I got lasered. Usually I can go by there without taking too much damage, but yeah, it was pretty bad. Targets is hard. Hopefully I can get a heart spawn from this guy up here. Oh no, yeah, I definitely need a heart spawn. Yeah, okay, got it. No, almost. He shot me before I could get the heart. Alright, this is probably gonna be a 306. Yeah, 307. Two deaths is really bad for escape.
Roger, roger.
Uh-oh. Died in an auto-scroller. Yeah, dying on escape is definitely a weird champ. But I did take a better angle in that final room, so we should be okay. Yes. What even is this? I think I saved a second over my 3013. At my 3013, I had a 306 or something. Where we're going, we don't need treaties. I mean, I don't know, for beginners at least, I think escape is deceptively hard, because that stage is basically all about jump timing. That's the only reason I didn't die in the end of that first room, even though 10 droids were shooting at me. And all of the droids' blaster bolts were in less than an inch off of my body. If two-player pod racers was faster, I would probably quit this game. Nice little break before feed. Escape is the fourth auto-scroller. Skipping those pulls is actually kind of hard. You have to, like, get accelerated halfway by the boost pad and then hold right. And you'll take a better line in the hallway. I learned that by watching Cool. Shouts to Cool. Can I get a shout out? Shouts to Zeddies for being in my chat way too long. Save the Jones, save the frames. This one goes out to Zeddies. Nice three. That was almost a four. That was a frame or two away from four. Really good ramp all three laps. Dude, mini kit scope. These are some god tier lines right now. Shoutouts to Simple Flips. Indeed, shoutouts to Simple Flips. I think I'm losing time in this last room. Shouldn't have taken such a far right turn there. Should have done it later. Because I think optimally you can take a bounce in that last pillar there, and you'll still get to the checkpoint, the final lap, pretty soon. Because, yeah, if you take a bounce in that second wall, like the second pillar, you will, you'll actually have a worse line going to the last line, so... Yeah, it definitely costs a bit. Alright, so, I have 27 seconds in Mall. Let's see if we can make it happen. Chase face. PR chase face. Dendy face in the chat. This chat needs some corn in the cob. This chat needs some steak in the cob. Okay, Kona. Hello? Why did that take a second to drop in? Weird. Didn't get dropped in immediately. Corn to God, brother. Okay, Kona. Oh no. That was a bad droids. I spent like 3 shots trying to shoot that last guy. I am doing the optimal character setups, I think. Cause yeah, you use Qui-Gon for both of these skips. Push Obi-Wan in advance. Hell no. What are you doing, AI? Don't know what R2 is doing there. Weird champ. Weird champ, dude. At least I got single clip. That was pretty optimal. Oh my god, I got push transition skip. Dude, I'm a god. Nice, nice. That was a perfect V2. Perfect. I got the push skip and everything. I think, yeah, push skips are like faster by humans compared to dropout. Alright, not gonna take a death in this last room. Let's go, dude. Fortunately, I had some mistakes in that droid room. When I realized it was out of balance, I was super excited. The backflip, dude. Okay, I could die actually up here. I could die up here. Nice. Okay, perfect. Got the backup strat. Saves 1 second over doing the jump. If only this is a better feed, dude. This would be insane. Well, not totally insane, but forcing the droid there is also pretty optimal. Oh no. That was dumb. I should have dropped him in way earlier. That was my fault. Yeah, I'm losing about 7 seconds, I think. Yeah, you want to drop in player 2 there when you're up against the wall so R2 can get past the ship. Otherwise, you're going to get that. What just happened there? I should still be ahead. Should stay about QB. Yeah, good. Alright. Let's do this. If I choke it, you know, just know that I have 30 seconds to save in the Jango fight, so. Alright, I'm not gonna look at chat for a bit. Nice backup. Alright, hard part's out of the way. My fault. Didn't hold X enough. Oh well. So I don't die during the boss fight, we should be still be fine. Even though the strider room's bad. Yeah, whatever. Yeah, two deaths is really bad. Oh well. Just gotta get berry skip and then we're good. Nice, got it. First try. Oh, almost died. Maka S. Maka Maka. Let's not stay near the edge when we're doing the last part. Play it safe. Can't wait, I still got that. Dude, the goal's been achieved. Let's go, dude. Thanks for the clip, Zeddies. Yeah, let's go. Dude, I'm so piped. I kept it together after I missed quick kill, dude. I just kept it going. Well, my dream is finally achieved. I'm so shocked. Well, I think I'll take a break for now. When I return, I'm gonna go for 101 without KDYF. GG, Waylon. Thanks to the people that helped me, well, first help me, you know, pick up this game. Shouts to Ultra and Cool and Blue for helping me. But yeah, this is a big day. Thank you.